Wonderful. So let's start from the beginning. Let's learn how to create basic projects in glitch.com, and then in the next videos we will learn how to customize them and how to work with them. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to sign up. So I already have an account, but I believe if you go to sign up, then you have like a bunch of options: Facebook, GitHub, blah blah blah, or just like your own account. I think in my case, I did back in the time sign up with my GitHub account. And then once you have signed up, then basically you will reach this dashboard where right now I have here a bunch of projects that I've worked in the past. You probably won't have much going on here. And then basically the way to create new projects is by going here to new project and choosing between one of the three templates that are available or cloning a project from GitHub. So, as I said before in my previous video, Glitch is specifically designed for web apps, and those basically fall under two categories. One of them is static websites, so websites that do not really have anything going on in the back end. So they are just simple HTML pages with perhaps some JavaScript code, but there's no user accounts, no logic, not anything working on the back end. So that would be the case, for example, of a Hello web page, which if I click, I am immediately sent to this project that is being deployed right now and that is being given an automatic name, which in this case is Nasal Juicy Tent, which is a very strange name. And also, you probably noticed that my screen is black because I did activate dark mode somewhere. I forget in my account. I'm not sure what I did that, but probably yours is white with black text. Where do I have dark mode? Change theme here. Yes, exactly. So probably yours looks something like this. I like dark mode better, so I'm going to work with this. You can see that here in my left panel, I have a bunch of files. So I have a simple HTML file that looks something like this. It's nothing fancy. I have a JavaScript script associated to it, and I have the styles, the CSS for this website, for this page. And if I go here to show, I can open in a new window the website that actually corresponds to this HTML that I have here. So for example, you can see that it's very simple. It has a header heading and it has a simple paragraph here. So for example, and what's nice about Glitch is that it's all very real-time connected, so if I make changes on the text, it will update very right away what I can see on the website. So for example, here I'm your new well cool web page that I am showcasing on Parametric Camp, which I should know how to spell, right? So I don't even need to save because it automatically auto-saves. And then you can see that my website has refreshed automatically, and now it has this thing, it has this new text that I added. A better way to even see that is to, instead of showing it in a new window, just showing, we can show it here next to the code. So for example, I'm going to enter here a new line character, and then we are live on the stream. Yoo-hoo! You see? And then you can see how the website is updating automatically. Similarly, if I inspect my website, you can see that in the console here, I have a hi message. That's because the script here says hi. So I could modify this and say hi, parametric campers. And I'm actually not sure if this is going to. Yes, hi, parametric campers. So is showing here on the console. So this is great, and this is really nice if you just want to put a static website that only has images, text, like something like your, I don't know, your homepage or something like that. What's also very nice is that immediately the route or the address of this website is nasaljuicytent.glitch.me. What that means is that if I share this code and I paste it, for example, I'm pasting it here on the chat on the live stream while I'm recording this, everyone can access that public website. So for example, if I type this here and I paste it on my browser, anyone from any browser can access that website at any given moment. And if I make any changes, for example, again, let me remove all this stuff here. You see, if I make any changes, those should broadcast right away to the other. And if they don't, you can just reload and things update. Okay. So that is how you can create a very simple website. And then you can add new files here. You can upload files. You can add new files and you can work with text here. And if I were to invite collaborators to this document, we will see each other and we could type together live. It's actually very nice and very intuitive. Now, the other way of creating a new project is by using a Hello Express template. So how can I explain this? Node.js on its own is a JavaScript runtime, but like very, very often, like 50% of 60% of why people use Node is to create web servers. And it turns out that to write the code to create a web server from scratch is kind of tedious. It takes a few lines of code. So there is this framework called Express, which makes that very easy and very fast. So this template here is specifically designed to give you a Node application that already has some boilerplate code, some basic stuff to be able to serve a website with a backend from using Express. So you can see that now the files that I have are very different. So you can see that I have a package JSON file, and we should be familiar with this. We should be familiar with this because we already know what package.json is. It's the file that describes the dependencies and the characteristics of my project. So here, the hello namespace, the main file is server.js, it's running Node version 12, and it has a dependency right now, which is Express. All right. And the server file is this one, which is a strange file. It does what it does is, what it does is it gives us this simple website that is living here on views and that we can use to add dreams and to create a dynamic website. So for example, I want to record 100 live streams. Okay. And it just shows up there. But what's interesting, regardless of this basic functionality, what's interesting is that this that we're running here is a full-fledged Node application that is running. And I can actually see how that's running by going, for example, to the logs. So you can see this log is basically the console that we had before in PowerShell. And this, here, for example, if I open a terminal, I could actually get into the backend, into the process, and type here ls, oh, what is this? Wait, ls. And then just also figure out all the files that are here and also as well trigger some process. So for example, I can print to the server.js and then I can print that to the console. Can I do nano? Oh, I can do nano. That's pretty cool, actually. All right. Okay. So I can access a tiny terminal that gives me access to the computer, to the tiny computer that is actually running this on the glitch.com server, which I think is really, really cool. Anyway, so what this means, and last but not least, I'm not going to cover the SQLite template, which is basically also a Node application that has a database that we can use to store data permanently, which is pretty cool. But I'm also, what I would like to show you also is importing from GitHub. So if you have a project that is already living on GitHub and it has, for example, the example files that I'm going to be using today, I have them here on GitHub, and you can see it's a simple WebSocket Echo server. It has the package JSON, it has the server JS, it has everything that we're going to be looking at today, and it has everything on this repository. So if I were to copy this GitHub link right now, and if I were to create a new project by importing it from GitHub, I can just paste here the link that of my GitHub repository, and if it's public, then Glitch will go and Glitch will go to GitHub. It will take all that code, it will clone it on this application, and then it will run it right away. All right, I don't know what happened there. It took a little bit to clone, but we can see that the project has been cloned and I have the package file, I have the server that I was writing before. And if I look at the logs, I see that there are some errors going on here, which I will have to fix in a second, but I will fix in the next few videos. But basically, I have cloned everything and now I have a copy of my GitHub repository on Glitch, which is really, really good also for starting projects if you don't want to start with the templates and you just want to do your own thing, okay? Which in our case, it's pretty convenient. So this was starting applications in glitch.com in a nutshell. So what I would like to do now in the next videos is, because this video is part of a larger series where we're looking at WebSocket technology and how to exchange data between different processes. What I would like to do next is to write an example with you all together, where we're going to deploy a WebSocket server on Glitch. It's going to be an echo server that is going to bounce messages back and forth. And we're going to see how to connect from clients to this server and use this server to exchange messages between different clients. It's going to be really cool. So If you want to learn more, check out the videos after in this playlist. And if you like this video, please consider subscribing, liking, etc. Thank you. See you in the next video.